everyone. My name is Rachel. I am one of your GTAs with Honors and Scholars. Specifically, I am the GTA for Academic Affairs, and part of my role is to help you develop your ePortfolio. So this video is going to just be a brief introduction to the ePortfolio, what it looks like, what it is, and what's included within the ePortfolio. So before we begin, if you haven't yet, please open the document that is at the top of the page you're currently on. There is a linked document. It's the ePortfolio workshop. Please complete that as you work through the different videos on this page. This workshop is a requirement of all incoming Honors and Scholars students, and that document is how we verify whether or not you've completed it. So once you submit that form, you'll receive an email stating that we reviewed the document and that the requirement is complete for you. So just again, if you haven't yet, please open that document and complete it. So that being said, I'll go ahead and share with you the ePortfolio. So it looks something like this. When you generate your individual site, your ePortfolio, it will look something like this. This is the template that they are all based on. And as you can probably see just from looking at these tabs, the ePortfolio is basically a compilation of all the different experiences that you'll have while at UT. And it's helpful to think about it that way and to think about it as sort of a living resume. So while you are developing this over the next 2 or 4 years, you're going to talk about and write about a number of different areas, a number of different experiences that you have. So some of it will be dedicated to your academics, what you're studying, papers and projects that you're proud of. You'll talk about a number of other experiences as well. So research that you get involved in, when you go abroad, that's something that you will definitely include. Community service that you do, involvement that you have on campus, the capstone project, which is sort of a culmination of your time with Honors and Scholars, will definitely be included on your ePortfolio. You'll reflect on various experiences, and then the ePortfolio is also home to some honor-specific requirements that you'll complete each semester. So as you can see, like I said, by looking at it, the ePortfolio is sort of like a living resume. It's a representation of everything that you do while you're at UT, everything that you're proud of and that you get involved in. And it's helpful if you think of it as a tool. So this is something that you can include on your resume, on your CV. This is something that you can provide to potential employers. You can put it on grad school applications. So it really is a tool. It's a place for you to sort of showcase yourself and the different things that you accomplish while you're at UT.